can see here. So this is the venture meter. In the exam, you need to draw this diagram only. For the 2D sketch, no need to draw 3D and all. So this from here to here, it is venture meter. So one end of the venture meter is connected to a pipe where you are going to measure the discharge. The another end of the venture meter is also connected to another end of the pipe. So venture meter consists of three major parts. One is a diverging end. This one is converging end, and the second part is at the throat, and from here to here, slowly there is an increase in length and as well as a decrease in area, decrease in the angle as well. So it is called as diverging end. Okay, so the angle between these two, this will be the very important point you remember for exam point of view as well as this big question may ask you in the gate exam or interview question. The total angle is 21 degree, but in the diverging end, the angle between these two plane will be at around 15 degree Celsius, 15 degree angle. And understood. So for what is, why they have given a 15 degree angle is to reduce formation of or eddies formation. Eddies formation means there will be some swirl motion in this area. For example, dear students, again, if you take like this, the diverging end also, if you increase the area like this, and the fluid flow through this, because of this sudden increase in the area, there will be formation of eddies. So there will be a backflow will create. Instead of flowing water from here to in this direction towards the right, towards the section 3, it will flow in the reverse direction. So when the flow takes place in the reverse direction, back pressure will be created. Here is one pressure, here is another pressure in the opposite direction. Then it creates some problem. It creates the losses and damage to the pipe as well as damage to the venture meter. So to avoid that eddies formation, the length of the diverging end is more. Okay. So now pressure is zero at this point. That is almost less pressure. And here pressure is high. When you are taking the high pressure here, obviously velocity will be less this point. Okay, so in this point, that is in this point means it is a throat. In the throat, the velocity is much more higher than the pressure. Pressure is too less. Okay, so between these two, I need to measure the pressure. So you have taken a vertical column. You can use a manometer or pressure gauges, any device to measure the pressure difference between these two. Here I have taken one pressure gauge and here is another pressure. So difference in these two pressure is represented by delta P, or we can take it is H. What is H? H is a pressure head or difference between point number one and point number two. Okay. P1 by rho z, P2 by rho z, that is what is considered in the previous equations, previous Bernoulli's equation numericals. Okay. So this is how the working of the venture meter. The conclusion points I will write here. Okay, what is the conclusion? What is venture meter? That is the first point you need to remember. Venture meter is a device used for measuring the discharge or flow rate of water, flow rate of liquid, or flow rate of fluid in a pipeline. The second point, the venture meter works on the principle of Bernoulli's equation. The third point, the venture meter consists of three major parts. One is converging end, and the second one is throat, and the third one is diverging end. The fourth point, what you need to remember here is the length of the diverging end is more than the length of converging end, because if you take the same length, the angle will remain same. If you take same angle on both the side, there is a formation of eddies. So due to eddies formation, the losses will be there. Due to losses, backflow will be created. So due to backflow, it may damage to the venture meter and the pipe. Okay, that is the fourth or fifth point. And you can also use the angle of diverging end. Diverging end angle is less compared to angle of converging end. So finally, using venture meter, you can measure the discharge. Okay, and sixth point, what you need to remember here is So between pressure and the pressure and the throat section, you can call it as throat section. This is called it as inlet section. Inlet section, throat section. At the throat section, the velocity will be more and the pressure is less. But in the inlet section, velocity will be less and the pressure is more. Okay, these are the some points you need to remember in the working and construction of a venture meter. In the next video, we will derive an expression for discharge through venture meter. Discharge through venture meter. Okay. So thank you for watching this video and take care. Bye bye.